If we look at the results compared to the control group, retinaldehyde treatment induced a, here's the key again, significant increase in epidermal thickness as well as cutaneous elasticity. What are the two things we're talking about in this video? Skin thickness, that means it's more robust, more collagen. Increase elasticity, because that's what the eye needs because it blinks. The eye. Have you ever wondered why some people just have the most beautiful eyes? It creates an attractive look for their overall appearance and their vibrance. They look awake, they look rested, and they look healthy. Other people, the under eye, the area above the eye, it just looks a little tired. It looks a little aged, and it really bothers people. Today, I'm going to tell you three things, three elements of the eye, and things that you can change and modify that you probably have not thought of up until now. And they're very important to address it. Now, as you know, the eye is complex. You have a brow, you have your eyelashes, you have, of course, the white of the eye, the under eye, and the eyelids. Also, the area around the eye plays a role. What exactly can you do to address all of these areas? Today, we're tackling the three most difficult ones. Number one being the skin, collagen, and structure around the eye, along with the discoloration. That's number one. A mouthful there, but let me tell you how to address it. The building blocks of course, your skin structure are your collagen and then your elastin. The eye blinks. That's great, but it's part of the problem. It's moving so many times a minute that the skin has to stretch constantly. And also because of what we eat, meaning too much salt, the way we sleep, alcohol, allergies, the skin here also stretches and is asked to contract a lot. And that's the problem. Here's the solution. The first thing to do is think about a vitamin C type of product, but not just any vitamin C. Most importantly is the newest form developed in Japan, no less. It's called THD asorbate, tetrahexyldecyl asorbate. Let's see what a PhD in skincare, a scientist who studies skin and products day in and day out, dedicated to skincare, has to say about this product.
I'm really excited about the technology and the innovation and the clinicals, but we have shown that this product can help enhance stagnant blood flow by 49%. So looking at the microvasculature in the under eye area.
Okay, so let's stop there for a minute. Blood flow. Deal with a lot of times in clinic, of course, we're trying to make that fat pad healthier, so I'm adding PRF, platelet-rich fiber, and of course, 90% of the world, 95% of the world, they don't want injections. That group, some of them will do the blood draw product, but in general, people want at-home solutions. When you're talking blood flow, now you're talking healthy fat pads, also lymphatics. Yes. From what we see in clinical practice, whether you've had under-eye fillers or not, if you have healthy lymphatics, your under-eye looks much better. Take us down the journey of where you're going with the increased blood flow.
So what we did is we utilized different types of techniques, cameras and laser Doppler, to actually measure blood flow in the under eye area.
Okay.
So we looked at baseline and after 12 weeks across greater than 30 patients, healthy women, but that had dark circles.
Yes.
And we found that there was an enhancement of that stagnant blood flow by 49%, which means that there was an improvement. And we actually had one of our scientific advisory board members, Dr. Corey Hartman, clinically grade, and he blind graded and saw that improvement as well.
That, I mean, we always look for objective evidence. You can't get more objective than Doppler blood flow.
Yes.
I mean, that's a very high percentage.
And that is 50 times more potent than the vitamin C you're placing on your face now, which is likely L-ascorbic acid. Look it up. The problem is, L-ascorbic acid, A, it's very unstable, so it oxidizes, and B, you're looking for the most acidic one. Check your serum or the liquid type of vitamin C that you're using as a standalone. I bet you the pH is somewhere around 2 to 3.5. That's too much for the delicate under eye. It's okay for your cheek, but not the under eye. So this THD asorbate is also fat soluble, and that means that you can mix it with a retinol. something we thought we could never do before. A lot of people thought, oh, you can't mix vitamin C and retinol. They don't mix. Well, it's because one's water soluble and one is not. And now with this new form, we can mix them and you don't get the amount of inflammation, but you get 50 times the potency and the skin tightening and building blocks for your collagen that go along with that and the retinol. This is the way to use a retinol around the eyes. And what do retinols do? They build collagen. They increase the turnover of cells, not that important in the under eye area because there's not a lot of pores and sebum that's produced, but it does build the collagen. And here's the kicker, vitamin C plus retinol has been shown to tighten the skin. Now let's look at this article to prove to you what we're trying to do. The efficacy of topical 0.05% retinaldehyde. That's the sweet spot for around the eyes. It's not too strong where you're going to get fat pad loss. Retinols, retinoics, retinaldehydes do not lead to fat pad loss, but for too many in clinical practice, what I see is they're using it and they're getting fat pad loss because of inflammation. So look for retinaldehyde. It converts to retinoic acid. And they looked at this in skin aging by ultrasound and rheological techniques. Let me look. I'll show you why this is important. If we look at the results compared to the control group, retinaldehyde treatment induced a, here's their key again, significant increase in epidermal thickness of the temples. That's where they studied it, as well as cutaneous elasticity. What are the two things we're talking about in this video? Skin thickness, that means it's more robust, more collagen, increase elasticity, because that's what the eye needs because it blinks. Similarly, retinaldehyde treatment tended to increase dermal thickness and reduce cutaneous stiffness. We're going to talk about calcium in a minute. We're also going to talk about temples in a minute. Taken together, the results further suggest that retinaldehyde has counteracting effects on the skin aging. We're not stopping there though. Why? Because often there's sunspots and dark circles. How are we attacking them? We want to use Even Glow pads. You want to use an AHA alpha hydroxy pad that also has lactic acid and antioxidants built in. That combination is what's going to give you the brighter eye, the tighter eye, and add to the building blocks of collagen, structure, and support, and elastin that your under eye demands.
On the retinol front, for those of you who have boosted your retinol gain with peel pads, you need to know this. Now, we talked about fat pad loss and having too strong of a product. Certainly, a peel pad is a strong product. But here's what you're looking for. An encapsulated form of retinol. You want a timed release. That's the key. Effectively delivered to the skin with proprietary transdermal carrier. Needs to have a carrier. If you're using something too harsh, then you are going to get inflammation, fat pad loss. So look for retinaldehydes in your topical forms. If it's a retinol peel pad, you want to look for something that's timed release. And of course, as a bonus, of course, we have that THD ascorbate in this product. So look for that in your product. So at the end of this video, check your products and see if you have this ingredient in them. I include them in my retinol tightening pads, my retinol A serum, and my Revision C Plus brightening under eye products. You can, of course, read more about them at store.rajanimd.com. Comment below this video. Let me know which ones are in your products.
That's step number one. Step number two, we're thinking about bone. Bone is oh so important. Why? Think about the loss of fat behind the eye. It's exaggerated when the orbit, the eye, gets larger and rotates the wrong way to look beautiful and youthful. So if you look at a young bone around the eye, it's fairly narrow bone structure. As we age, it widens and rotates down, and that takes the brow with it. And when the brow is angled down like that, that says tired, and it helps bring the lid down. So you have to pay attention to the bone around the eye. Well, that sounds very difficult, right? Particularly because females are going to lose bone around when? Menopause, 45 to 55, those bony changes occur. But I want you to think about it around the age of 35, and here's what you want to think about. vitamin K2, D3. This is where I found out about it, because I was interested in maintaining the bone around the face, because I saw so many women looking older from bone loss. So vitamin K2 helps take the calcium, put it into the bone and away from the elastin and away from the soft tissues and tendons. Why away from the elastin? If calcium goes into your elastin, you lose your contractility of it and you get laxity. So recall, we talked about the blinking of the eye. Imagine calcium in the muscles, the tendons and the ligaments around the eye. Now you get the picture, leading to wrinkles. Let's prevent that. Let's do it naturally and simply with supplementation and foods. It also helps with the heart, mind you. We do a calcium test in the heart to check for heart disease. And again, you don't want calcium in the vessels around the heart. You want it in your bone. But you need calcium, right? So that's why we combine vitamin K2 with D3. Vitamin D3 does many things, including immune boosting, but it also helps you absorb calcium. So vitamin K2, D3 is something to really look at and consider. Also think about hormone replacement therapy. Have a whole video on that, but as estrogen goes down, so does your calcium. Something easy you can do, exercise helps build bone, and you want to think about three specific ones, of course, the squat, the deadlift, and the shoulder press. And this is from a well-studied trial called the LIFT-MORE trial. So all the things you want to do to maintain your bone, to stay active, and of course, consider early scanning of the bone, because some women particularly have to go on a special drug that helps put calcium into the bone and restore bone more aggressively. But your DEXA scan, your scan of your wrist or your hip that's going to assess the amount of calcium in your body will help you with that. You want to know earlier rather than later. In my opinion, the guidelines tell you to do it way too late. Prevention is always better than cure. Maintain your bone. Number three, you haven't probably thought of this one unless you follow my videos, but it's the temple. As you hollow the temple, not only do your eyes look more close together, your face doesn't look youthful because now you have a hollow here. The mind calculates a hollow temple and says, that's an old person. That is not youthful. Youthful has fat. And as we age, especially if you're fit, unfortunately, which is good, you want to be fit, you're probably leaner than most. And because of that, you're also losing some fat in your face, especially double, triple hit are the runners, the triathletes, the cyclists who are in the sun, kills the fat pads. Also sometimes kills the bone if you're over-exercising. And then the sun, of course, causes its inherent damage and you get a hollow temple. And it says age. Of course, you typically are going to have more sunspots as well. It's a cascade of symptomatology. However, let's talk about reversing that. We can fill the temple. We can add volume back. And in that way, it lifts the edge of the eye, especially if you use something special, skin tighteners with it. What tightened skin that we could put up here? Well, there's two things. All natural is the best way to go, and that is something called plasma fill, where you draw your own blood, you spin it down, you get your growth factors, your exosomes, your stem cells, make it into a gel, and you put it in the temple. For many years, I did not put it in the temple, thinking it won't stay. Now, through 3D imaging, I know we fill the temples and it maintains. Another option would be something like Sculptra. Better yet, up here, you can go to permanent, and in that case, you want to think of a product called Bellafill. Bellafill will last you your life. It takes a couple of vials per temple, but it helps lift, it does help tighten the skin, and it does build collagen around it. Filling the temple, taking care of the skin and the collagen and the structure, maintaining the bone around the eye, then allows you to consider things like the brow and brow hair, which of course you can use PRF for, which you already used to fill the temple, so you have it drawn anyway. The lashes, the lids, and the fat pad behind the eye, and that all gives you that beautiful looking eye. Now you're going to want to watch this video on how you can make a DIY skincare product at home, and one down here on your overall blueprint skincare routine to keep your eye and your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.